Hey, good morning, YouTubers. Sawmill Bro 70 here. Down here at the sawmill shed. And I want to get ready for the weekend. Brian's coming over, my son. And we're going to get another one of these logs cut up, and I'll show you what we're going to get. This is the one I'm after today. And I think it's 14 foot long. And, it's like, I don't know, you judge for yourself. I say ugly. Now we're going to get some nice lumber out of this, but it's going to take some cutting to get this stuff, get this thing ready for the mill. So I'll bring you along. I'll hopefully pick this up. I don't know if I can or not. It's a pretty big log. So we'll try, see what happens. And hope I don't hit any bees' nests. So I'll be back and bring you along to this exciting moment. A big log. Anyway, I want to bring it up here and lay it so I can start cutting on it. Well, I don't know how well this is picking us up in the sun. But anyway, got some big knobs to cut off here. So I'll probably get the Husqvarna 24-inch and knock these off from the top. And you can see the back side here. I've got knob there, knob there, knob there. Got a knob there, knob there. Wow, not counting what's on top and on the other side. A lot of cutting. And that's what you guys like to see. So, I will be back. Okay, I am going to start with this big, ugly, rotten limb that was sticking out of this tree. Wow. That limb that come off of there was probably bigger than most trees I cut. But anyway, I gotta hack at that so let's see how this goes. Wow, didn't go bad though, it cut nice. I don't know where to go with it. Now the good news is that the saw seemed to stop smoking, so it could have been the fuel. But anyway, Okay, we're gonna go over here now.
Thank you.
I don't know if you can see them, but there was a massive amount of them. Okay, all right, here's the next victim. Ah! Okay. Now you've got to ask yourself, and I know you're questioning what I did there. I think it makes sense. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. This is the big end. And I don't know what it measures, but it looks to be somewhere above 30 inches. And this is the small end. I went to the big end because if I can't make it to the big end, then I can't finish the log. But if I have it the other way, if I start in there, I could get clear up to here on the log and find out I can't make it. Then I have to back the mill out. So if I can make it at this end, I will make it this end with ease. So it kind of takes the guesswork out of stuff. So anyway, I think I missed a knob I could cut right here. I might have cut that, but not enough. So I think I'm going to whack it again. Pulled my guts out, I realized I didn't turn it on. Okay, that's going to be it. Now this is the ugliest log of all of them. And 28 inches at the big end. And 24 inches at the small end. And it's 13 foot, 11 inches. 13 foot, 11 inches long. So we might cut some off of this, I don't know. I'll leave that up to my son. His log. But anyway, I hope you understood that, why I put the big end first. If I can get through the big end, I'm okay down at the other end. That way I'm not stuck halfway through the log and can't make it. I've done that too many times. But anyway, that's going to do it for this video. I appreciate everyone watching. And hope you enjoyed it. It's it for me. And I will catch you all in the next video. And whenever that will be, I'm getting close to, I'm getting some new electronic stuff in, and like a new computer and stuff, so I don't know how long it's going to take to switch that over, but I hope I can still upload with the old computer. I'm keeping it just in case, but I'm not a whiz at computers by any means. So anyway, catch you on the next video. Thanks for watching.